evening, everyone. My name is Phil Conway, and I'm just grateful to be able to share this time with everybody here today. And I just wanted to thank also again Ed Rhodes and Frank for hosting this space here. I have a friendship that professionally goes back with Ed for years, and our family business where I operated as a funeral service professional. I really love working with families and helping them move through the healing towards their healing, and having events. And working in a family business, it was unique because I had three generations we worked together. My grandmother did bookkeeping until she was 86. And then we said we have to learn computers and have the computers working with us. So it has interesting dynamics when you work in a family business and always knowing there could be something more. So I figured it's not just what I was doing, but I also wanted to touch more people, figure out how I could reach things. So I was always a student in figuring out where I could learn. And I'm just curious for everybody here, do you work in a business by yourself, or do you work with a small team, or are you as an employee? Kind of a mix of everything, right? Yeah. So, you know, what I just really love working is I usually work with small and medium-sized businesses, and really just how to think, act, and so we can serve differently. And one of the things that I had a mentor that I came across, it was such powerful information with Bob Proctor, that I decided to go into business with him and learn how do we take tools, resources, and really start to achieve whatever it is that we wanted. I know I was just getting a divorce. We had a business marriage that really wasn't the best, and going through some financial and time challenges, waiting 20 years for things to make a shift, and it didn't happen. I didn't want to see anybody else have to go through that type of thing. So this is why I became a certified consultant, and I got involved in an organization called CEO Space. In CEO Space, we have the idea of collaboration. I like how Jason was talking a little bit about collaboration and how do we end the idea of competition in business and in life. And when we do that, we can do some phenomenal things. So I want to share with you some concepts of how we can, no matter where we are now, if we're just looking to start out, if we're looking to add, we're looking to build, that we can do that. It's so interesting how at CEO Space, Bernie Dorman and Ed Deming were two people who were together, and they became partners, and they started coaching people, and they started to build a network. And at CEO Space, I learned we can always find ways to have, whether it's joint ventures, have strategic partners. So I love collaborating, finding strategic partners to work together. And back in the pandemic, Bernie Dorman had been warning us about what was going on, is that we were going to have an economic winter that was going to be 5 years. So when you think of it, we're 2 years into what could be a winter. And one of the things I'm going to share with you is some information, get right into the root cause, because quite often we don't always do what we know how to do, but we can always look to and say, do we want to let the outside world control where we want to be, or do we wait to take control of ourselves? I didn't want to be the family business person who just wasted my life away waiting for things to happen. I had always a bigger picture of things. I think big. I'm thinking, for example, who's going to be the first trillionaire? We heard Ed mention $1 trillion. Will Elon Musk be the first one? Or how many other people will be trillionaires? We're talking millionaires and billionaires. But quite often, most people don't want to be that. All they want to do is be able to be where they are, whenever they want to be, and be able to do what they want to do. They don't have to be able to, you know, measure it off huge, you know, $1 million or whatever, but all they want to do is be free. So I'm going to share with you some concepts. How do we, in a game, it's about awareness. So I'd love to leave with you an awareness of how do we get into the power of, it's 95% mindset and 5% skill set. And how can you apply that today? So to get an awareness. In the short time, I'll share some concepts, and there's many more things I can talk about, but I want to leave you with something to know you have your awareness, and there's also questions and answers, and happy to answer anybody around here today. Sometimes live without Zoom, so maybe if everybody can just, if you have a phone, put it in front so that I can see the squares, and maybe the squares would be socks off. That's really powerful information. And so just to keep an open mind today, wherever we're looking, we can look, I don't know if that's dark enough that people can see. We have results, and they can either be positive
are negative. One of the things I'm going to talk about today is that we think in pictures, and how do we come up with pictures to know where we're going? And if we're setting a destination, a goal, how do we get to that point? Hopefully that'd be better, thank you. How do we get to that point? And when people are really don't have a clear idea where they're going, if they have an understanding that the power is in our subconscious mind, because that's where everything is, the results are just a reflection of what's going on in the inside and where I want to go. And then having an idea of believing in ourselves. So the idea of looking at our mind. If people talk about mindset, there's two things we can talk about. We can control internally our thoughts and our attitude. Everything else we have no control over. And if we can just allow ourselves to get to a point where all the thoughts that we're thinking, are we choosing the thoughts that we want? Or are we choosing the thoughts that we don't want? And that's where I'm going to show to you a picture of the mind, because if we're allowing thoughts that we don't want, that's going to reflect in the results we see. If we only allow the thoughts that we do want, those will be the results. So if we're into its economic winter, and there's always a rhythm in science, there's rhythm like the seasons. Here it's fall, we're feeling it fall right now. And everything works that way. It's up and down, the tides come in and out. And if we understand that, well, if, like Bernie Dorman said, if we're 5 years away from having economic things going well, if the average business may not grow, what does that probably mean? If, in general, if you have 100 businesses, 35 might fail, they might be a negative revenue, 20 might be average, and 30 might triple their results. The difference between those who are tripling their results and those who are failing is how they are thinking and how they're approaching their business. If they're investing in themselves and they're investing in their teams and they're aware of where they can go, and if the idea of collaboration, they find different strategic partners, and the idea is that where professionals will always be creative, professionals will be innovative, amateurs will always compete. I was on a Blue Ocean strategy group where we used to go around figuring out what are unique businesses, how we have life milestones celebrated in ways. I don't know if you heard the book Blue Ocean Strategy. There, that for example, an airline like Southwest Airlines. Southwest Airlines was not competing with airlines, they were competing with the bus. So they chose cities to go to that were going to be where the bus would go. And so it just a little bit more than what a bus, you could get there faster. Starbucks Coffee was not looking to compete with Dunkin' Donuts Coffee. They were looking to give people 25 minutes of their time. Cirque du Soleil was taking the expensive part of the circus out of the animals, and they were creating a combination of theater, so they were able to charge more. So when this is going on, in times of change, the learned will inherit the earth, while those who were, the learners, I should say, will inherit the earth, while the learned will find themselves beautifully equipped to live in a world that no longer exists. So how do we be innovative, move forward, and be that 35% of the businesses that are going to grow no matter what? It's going to be by having your minds closed tightly against negative thoughts and what people, other people might say, or what the environment might be. And you all have the power to do that. The question is, do you believe that yourself, or do you not believe that? And that's for each person to decide. But we always had an amazing book that my mentor, Bob Proctor, was given. He grew up in the Depression, and he couldn't hold a job. He had 25 jobs in 8 months. He couldn't make it anywhere. And then someone saw this book, and Bob, I think he was earning $4,000 and he owed $6,000 in the early 1960s. And once he started studying this, he started to turn things around so that the following year, he was an unconscious confident. He was able to do things in a way, and he couldn't figure out why. He started cleaning the companies in 5 different cities, and you know, by studying every day, he was doing this unconsciously, but then he said he wanted to know why. So like him, I want to study what gets to our power source. How do we get to the power, how our results are driven? So that's what I want to share with you today, how we start to make a shift. No matter where we are, we've never tapped into our potential, and we can always grow more. Have an understanding where in our mind, if we drew a picture, Dr. Thurman Fleet, 1934, he was active in the holistic health field, and he talked about the idea of mind-body connections. So in order to understand the mind-body connection, we had to know, what is the mind? How many people would probably say, well, it's the brain. If we think of it, we probably think of the brain. If we understand the brain is just a part of our anatomy that's an electronic switching station, we understand all the energy that moves in and out, the idea of where does that power come from, and to our areas of the mind called the conscious mind, or the subconscious mind. But if we just have a word, subconscious, conscious, that still doesn't bring clarity. So the idea, and I put a picture in the back if you want to take it, it's called a paradigm shift. How do we start looking at things differently? And the idea of understanding how this was one of the most powerful concepts that Bob Proctor had ever come across was understanding if this whole circle here is your mind, understanding that an unconscious mind is our thinking mind, and the subconscious mind is our emotional mind, and then our conscious mind has five antennas that we call our five senses. So we have see, hear, touch, taste, and smell. And our conscious mind connects to the outside world through our five senses. How many times do we say, oh, I see my results, I see where I am, and I start to think of where my results are, and I don't believe I can make a shift. When we start to understand that we also have filters, we have six mental muscles called perception, our will, our memory, our reason, our intuition, and as Einstein called one of the most powerful mental muscles, imagination. Any of us can think of a picture. If you were to go to, for example, your kitchen, if you wanted to know what your refrigerator looked like, right now you went into your mind, you thought, oh, where do I go in my kitchen, to go to the right or the left? I'll look at my refrigerator. Is it a door that's side by side or top and bottom? Does it open right to left? You go in your mind to access that because we think in pictures. Everything comes in pictures, and then we use a word to describe that picture. So we have to keep a picture of our mind, understanding that here's these powerful forces here, and they're in our conscious mind, and say they operated for, if it was a rocket ship, if it was a jet, say, in 1,000 miles an hour, the subconscious mind is a million times more powerful, operates faster than the conscious mind. So when you start to have an awareness that it's the subconscious emotion that drives us, and then one of the big things is when we have these emotions of having a goal and a destination, that is how things start to happen, because what happens is that we have our conscious mind, we have our emotional mind, and that's where our habits are stored. We have an operating system. We have an operating system that was ingrained in us through years since we were a baby. And this is how advertising, for example, works. Say we see an ad, we hear an ad, and it comes into our conscious mind. We have the ability to either accept that thought or reject that thought. And that's where our attitude would help us say, okay, I either accept what somebody is saying, because it gets planted into the subconscious mind. That's why advertising is effective, because people are getting a message and it's repeated. And as people start to do that, they start to buy the particular product. Well, the same thing for us is that we understand that we can originate our own ideas too through our imagination and through our pictures. So when we start to do that, we start to take control instead of letting the outside world take control. Things become different for us. And because of our operating system is a fancy word called a paradigm. And a paradigm is nothing more than a multitude of mental habits. It is ideas, thoughts, beliefs, images of what we believe is possible. And as we have those ideas or thoughts, it controls our unconscious behaviors, and almost all of our behavior is habitual. Think of it for example, if you were getting up in the morning, by the time you get to work, did you think about getting up, getting dressed, getting in the car, getting here? You just got there. If you were out at night and you were going home, you don't think about your ride home, you just get in your car, you drive, and before you know it, you're home. And that is how most of us were on autopilot and would just allow ourselves to drift. So the people who are going to be, in the minds of people who are in that 35% that are growing, they're the ones that are taking control of their thoughts. They're not allowing that habit to happen automatically. They start to install ways, and there's ways that I show people how they can start to have a shift in what they think and how they can install a new program. Mm-hmm. Think of a software, for example. If we have 1.0 or if we have 2.0, we start to have results. You start to look back, for example, when you were much younger, you didn't know how to drive a car, but now you do. Think of an example of your business. If you have a goal, you can be an employee in an organization that really is good for you. And Jeff's going to talk about how to get connected a little bit today. If we have people who can support us and reward us for the ideas that we come, you know, we can think of an idea. How do we have, for example, 20 questions every day? How do I improve customer service? How do I improve my skills? How do I have a direction that we've never gone before? Or am I only going to look outside at what's possible? Am I only going to look at being 3% growth as opposed to what if I wanted to double? All of that is possible. Nothing is big or small. It's only our thinking that makes it so. So the idea of controlling our thoughts, and this is a lot of information, it's like a fire hose to get through, but I just, in the short period of time, I wanted to leave you with the idea that there's an awareness and to help you to get on the path to understand. I have resources that I have here. I just brought a couple of books to show you, like, for psychokinetics, we have an automatic success mechanism in our mind. It's about how we see ourselves. The way we see ourselves is going to determine all the achievement that we have in life. If we look at businesses, we can know that to the level of the development of the people who are in leadership, that's the extent to where results will be shown. If the person is not going to be growing or changing, then the results of that business are not going to change. We can change in a moment, although it takes a while to install that program, but having a clear picture of our mind and the power of the mind, that's where it starts to make a difference. And it's something that we work on day by day by day. It's about making a decision that I want something different, I want to have this result, and I want to change the habits. Think of yourself, how many times have you tried to lose weight and you said you still had that chocolate cake, you still had the dozen donuts, you still had lasagna at 10 o'clock at night, you still had 5 drinks when we should have probably thought of having water, we should have thought about eating healthier, eating salad. Those are the ideas of the old paradigm, controlled by habits, because it's so easy to do. Jim Rohn had the saying that the things that are easy to do are also easy not to do. So if we want to be in control of the results to improve, we have to start taking control of ourselves, and it's about making a decision. I have got a great article on how do we make a decision and how do we start to take those steps, and that's really what I want to do today, is to share, have that power of awareness and, okay, so the idea of having a picture of our mind and then a picture of the destination. If you like coffee, you have to know if you're going to go to Starbucks, or you have to know if you're going to go to Dunkin' Donuts. If we don't have a clear picture, how do we know we're going to go? So in our idea of having a picture of our goal, we have to have that specific. It has to be mentioned, you know, I just say it's 100K. That might be one goal, but somebody else might be, I just want to have more time off. Somebody else might say, I just want to be able to take a vacation and not have to worry. And the idea for what is a goal is A, B, or C. A goals are things you've done before. If you bought a new car before, that's not a good goal. If you're a business, you've earned $1 million. How many people say they get the same results 1 year, 2 years, 3 years? Did you ever have the same income more than 2 years in a row? Only because the subconscious is programmed that way and you don't believe anything's different, and that's why it doesn't change. When you start to shift what you can think and you just ask yourself a question, a shift can happen. And I can start to say, well, what if the external circumstances were different? And what I wanted to say to you is that we don't have to depend on the external circumstances. We can have a mind closed to outside circumstances and people and thoughts, and we can change our behavior, and all we have to do is come to a mind of service to others and have collaboration, find innovative ways. And if we set that goal that we've had the same thing for year after year, that's an A-level goal. The B-level goal, that's thinking sports. That's like the Patriots making the playoffs. They know they're going to make the playoffs, maybe not this year, but many other years that they've been doing it. And then the C-level goal, those are the things, that's where life gets interesting. That's where it's something that you never want to do. You're both excited and scared, and it's the fear that holds us back. So the idea that when we're living in fear or faith, it's just about an energetic vibration. We have this idea of frequency and vibration. We can either allow fear to stop us, or we can have faith. And faith is seeing the invisible, so we can believe the incredible. And that way we can have what everybody else calls the impossible. But it's an idea of keeping our thoughts on the positive side. What is it that we want? We plant an idea. The idea gets planted into our heart, into our subconscious mind. And that's where we decide to have a reprogramming. We start installing new software into our mind. And that creates new habits. And it's those new habits of the actions that we take. And like in physics and science, whatever action we push out is a cause and effect. That's what will happen, and we have to have our results based on that. So this is a very fast overview of the power of mindset and the power of having awareness and the power that we do all have. There's no exceptions. Everybody can, if you, whatever it is that you want. You want to double your income, you want to turn your annual salary into a monthly salary. And so what I'd like to ask to you, when it comes to setting C goals and stretch goals, some of you ever heard of the word stretch goals before? A stretch goal is doing things that you haven't done before, but the idea is not to achieve 100,000. That's never what the purpose of a goal is. The goal is, who do I become? How do I think like the person who achieves $100,000? How do I behave? How do I treat other people? You can make that $1 million, and there's no difference. It's only our thinking that makes $1 million different than 100,000. But most of us are not programmed to allow ourselves to think bigger than 100,000. And that's how those 30% who are not going to do well, because they're paying too much attention to interest rates or government or, you know, what did our customers say. But if you have something that's value and you offer that, you start thinking differently and you serve differently. When that starts to happen, that's where the magic is, because that's when you have the impossible. So think for yourself, what are some habits that work for you? Write it down. Take a quiet hour, morning and night. What are the habits that don't work for you? How would you need to think if you had that level where you really want to be? Not what you accept as tolerate, but really where you want to be. And I just want to leave you with the awareness that you can be there, and it's helping you along the way. I like to offer you a free blueprint. We can take 30 minutes in your personal situation or your team and see how it is that you could make some adjustments here or there. Perhaps it's a resource. Perhaps it's an introduction, and I offer that to you, or even just articles. I have some great articles to share, maybe how to make a better decision, how to take risk, or just how to have a picture of where I want to go, and stop thinking, using your imagination more. So that's what I wanted to leave you with. You have the power to make things different and not let this economic winter take a hold of you. You get a chance to live that life that you want. And I just want you to know it's available for everyone who wants to have that for themselves. So that's the very short, I think 3 hours and 10 minutes.